Dear students, I am Dr. Pooja Sharma, Associate Professor of Department of MBA in SIRTE. Today I will discuss about the topic journal entry. As you know, it is the primary book or original book of entry and in which the transactions are recorded. First of all, this is the book which is the base of all the recording, in which the transactions are recorded systematically and date wise. It is also known as original entry book or prime entry book. Journal is one of the book of original entry in which transactions are originally recorded in a chronological order or on the basis of the double entry system. So for which, when you are preparing journal entry, you need to understand the concept before that, double entry system. What are the rules of golden rules of accounting? You need to understand that, then you can just pass the entry in this book. So before starting this, I have just taken in my previous lecture about the golden rules of accounting. So you need to just see that also. Now the journal entry. Journal is a date-wise record of all the transactions with details of accounts debited and credited and the amount of each transactions. Here you know all the transactions has dual effect. So transactions have dual effect. So one part of that is debited and second is credited. So need to see that which one should be debited and which one should be credited. And each of that transaction will record, each of that account will record in book of the journal entry. This is the format of journal entry book. The columns have been numbered only to show how the journal is written up. Here you just see the explanation of that. Date, in date, in the first column, the date of the transaction is entered. The year and the month is written only once till they change. So on the top of the journal entry, you will write the year, you will write the month. Particulars, each transaction affects two accounts. One is debit, another one is credit. The name of account to be debited is written first, and very near to the line of the particular column, and the word debit is also written in front of the at the debit side. In front of that, you need to write the amount of that. In the second line, the name of the account is to be credited is written. Starts with word to. Third column, narration you will write in that. In particulars, you will write the narration also. After each entry, you will write a brief explanation of the transaction. Actually, the narration helps to know in future the reason of the entry and why you have recorded that and what are the other circumstances, what are the discount features, trade discount, you know, can know about this with the help of the narration. Ledger folio, all the entries from the journal are later posted into the ledger account. So this is shows basically the page number. It is the page number on which you will write the ledger folio, the ledger account number on which the entry will be posted in near future. Debit amount, in this column, the amount of the account being debited is written. In credit amount, in this column, the amount of account being credited is written. So these are the columns in which you need to write the different aspects of the entry or any transaction. Steps in journalizing. First, you need to understand that how you can journalize the transaction, how you can pass the entry in the book of accounts, in the original book of accounts. First, determine the two accounts which are involved in the transaction. Means first you need to see that which one should be debited and which one should be credited. And this should be done on the base of the double entry system. Step 2, classify the above two accounts under the personal, real and nominal account, in which category it will lie. Personal account, real account and nominal account rules are the part of the double entry system. Third step, find out the rules of debit and credit for the above two accounts. Step 4, identify which account is to be debited and which account is to be credited, as I told you. Step 5, record the date of transactions in the date column, and the year and the month is written once only. As I told you, the year and month you will write on the top of the book. The sequence of the dates and months should be strictly maintained. And at the end of the each page, both in debit and credit columns are totaled up just in front of each other. So these total must be equal. This is the most important thing. When you are just passing the entry in the book of account, at last you will just add the debit amount and the credit amount, and it should be equal to each other. Means debit amount total should be equal to the credit amount. That shows all the transaction which you have passed is correct, are correct. Step 6, enter the name of the account to be debited in the particulars column. Step 7, write the name of the account to be credited in the second line, starts with the word 2. Step 8, write the narration. As I told you, each transaction after the passing the entry, you need to narrate it, you need to explain that transaction. Step 9, draw a line across the entire particular column to separate one journal entry from the other. Now these are few illustrations of journal entry. First example, January 1st, 2020, Soham started business with rupees 1 lakh. So analysis of this transaction is what? Here you can just see Soham started the business. So he is the owner of the company, he is the proprietor of the company. So whenever, as per the double entry system, whenever the proprietor or the owner will start the business, we will not write the name of that very person in the books of account. We will write the representative only. So the representative, you just see the first step, determine the two accounts involved in the transaction. So the first account here is cash is coming in the business, and the capital is also, capital represents the name of the Soham representative. Here the capital is the representative of Soham or the proprietor of the business. Step 2, classify the accounts under personal, real and nominal. So the real account comes in the cash comes in the category of the real account, and capital comes in the category of personal account. Step 3, find out the rules of debit and credit. Here the cash is coming in the business, that should be debited, and capital is who is the giver here? Soham. And we are writing the name of the we are not writing the name of the Soham, we are just writing the name of his representative. So there will be, we'll write the capital, so the he is the giver, so we'll just credit the giver. Step 4, identify which account is to be debited and credited. Cash will be debit as per real account rule, and capital will be credit as per the personal account rule. So the transaction will be like this, entry will be like this. Cash account in date column we will write January 2020 year, and on the top of that, and then we'll write the date January 1st, and the in particulars we'll write the entry cash account debit to capital account. The narration will be like this, the amount invested in the business. In debit side we are writing 1 lakh rupees, and in credit side in front of the capital write again 1 lakh rupees. In laser folio I have just written the page numbers on which these entry will be posted. For your example, now example 2, January 3rd, 2020, received cash from Balram, ₹25,000. So here you can just see, determine the two accounts involved in the transaction. So the first is cash and second is Balram. Step 2, classify the accounts under the personal, real and nominal. Cash will come in the real account, as the assets will come in the real account. And Balram is the name of the person, so we'll count it in personal account. Step 3, find out the rules of debit and credit. Real account, as cash is coming in the business, that's why it should be debited. And who is the giver? Credit the giver. Who is the giver here? Balram. So Balram is to be credited. So the entry will be like this. Cash account debit to Balram's account. Narration will be cash received from Balram. So this is the entry for the second example. Now the compound journal entry. When two or more transactions of similar nature take place on the same date, such transaction can be entered into the journal by means of a combined journal entry. It's called combined journal entry, compound journal entry. And then only precaution is that the total of debit should be equal to the total of credit. It is most important thing with the compound entry. So I've just taken one of the example of the compound entry. June 1st, 2020. Anju contributed capital rupees 50,000. Manju contributed capital rupees 70,000. So you can just see in the entry, previously I have just given that same example with the one person. Now I have just taken the example in which two proprietors are invested money. So the cash will be debited as per the real account rule. It is the asset of the business. So asset should be debited always. Anju is the contributor, or Anju is the investor or proprietor, Anju and Manju. So we can write like this: Anju's capital and Manju's capital. In this way we can pass the entry cash account debit to capital account, Anju's capital and to Manju's capital, and we can just pass the entry like this: 1,20,000, and in front of the Anju's capital we like 50,000, and capital of Manju will write 70,000. The total amount will be 1,20,000, and both are investing cash in the business, so we cannot write the separate entry. We don't need to write this pass the separate entry for this. Thank you so much. That's all for today.